Good morning, 9th class. Today our chapter is number 9 and name of the chapter is Force and Laws of Motion. Total 7 topics are there and we have already completed up to 9.5, second law of motion. And today we are going to complete 9.6, third law of motion and 9.7 also conservation of momentum. Topic 9.6, third law of motion. We have definition, related examples, and then concept behind third law of motion. So look at this figure. What you are observing, we have hand, and then this one is spring balance A, and second spring balance, and it is named B. So A spring balance and B spring balance, and this B1 is connected with the wall, right? So all these are interlinked, right? And then here action is done by this hand, that means action is felt in this first A spring balance, and then reaction is observed in the second one. Then after action and reaction, what is going to happen here? Just look here, what is the reading? 1, 2, and 3, right? After skipping first, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Total they are 4 readings, and here 1, 2, 3, 4, so they are equal, that means forces are equal, but opposite. Just look here, in this direction and this one is in this direction, so forces are equal but opposite, understood? So action and then reaction, forces are equal, right, but in opposite direction. So can you guess action and reaction forces equal and opposite? Newton has given total 3 laws. So which law deals with this concept? Answer is third law of motion, right? Very good. So here is the definition. To every action there is an equal and opposite reaction, and they act on two different bodies, right? In our figure also we have two spring balance. In A there was action and in the other one there was reaction, understood? Next is about example. So example number one, here we have gun and here we have bullet, right? So force is given by this bullet on gun, and gun also gives force to bullet, right? So force of this bullet and force of this gun, both are equal, they are moving in opposite direction. Bullet moves in forward direction and gun moves in backward direction, right? And when you compare, means force formula is F is equal to ma. So when you compare masses, then mass of bullet is less as compared to mass of gun, right? So if mass of bullet is less, that means acceleration of bullet is more, right? Acceleration iska zyada hoga aur iska acceleration kam hoga. Acceleration ka matlab kya hota hai? Rate of change in velocity. So change in velocity, velocity change here is more, that means speed with the direction is more, speed of this bullet is more in a particular direction, and speed of this gun is less. Why? Because mass is more, right? And for this, what you have, action is by this bullet and reaction is by this gun. So this figure is from your textbook 9.11, a forward force on bullet and recoil of the gun. Next we have example number 2. So here 9.12 figure from your textbook, as the sailor jumps in forward direction, the boat moves backward. So the sailor is moving forward direction and the boat is moving backward direction. So action is given by this man and the boat is doing reaction, and both forces are equal but their direction is opposite. So this one is third law of motion. Next we have a look at this figure. This figure is a activity of your textbook, figure 9.13, right? What all you are observing, these are two cart wheels, right? And here a girl and a boy, and this boy is having a bag in his hand, right? So and when you compare masses, mass of this girl is less as compared to mass of this boy. So when force is given by the boy to the girl, right, action is given by this boy and reaction is felt by this girl, right? So reaction is in the form of motion of this cartwheel. This cartwheel moves in this direction and this moves in this direction, right? The boy's cartwheel moves in this direction. ये वाला इस direction में जाएगा और ये वाला cart इस direction में जाएगा. जब ये boy इसको अपना pass करेगा तो motion दोनों cart में होगा. But motion आप सोच सकते हो किस में सबसे ज़्यादा होगा? This girl. Okay, क्यों? Because mass of this, when you are observing here, mass of this girl is looking less, right? So if mass is less, acceleration of this cartwheel is more, right? Because forces are equal and opposite. Understood? Next, we have the concept behind the figure. So total we have three concepts. That means forces are equal and opposite, right? And number second is masses of two bodies are different. So acceleration of the two bodies must be different. Clear? So in any case, if masses are different, that means acceleration must be different, right? And number third is action and reaction act on two different bodies. Right? So they never takes place on the same body, right? Next we have topic 9.7, conservation of momentum. And in this we have diagram, derivation, statement and then related numerical. So here is our figure. First observe this figure very carefully and understand each meaning, right? MA means these all blue structures are ball, right? MA means mass of ball A. It is moving with initial velocity UA. Mass of ball B moving with initial velocity UB. Clear? And both the balls are moving same straight line, on the same straight line. Clear? And here the condition is UA must be more than UB. दोनों एक ही स्ट्रेट लाइन में जा रहे हैं तो नेचुरली जो पीछे चल रहा है उसका वेलोसिटी ज़्यादा होगा ही, राइट? ज़्यादा होगा ये, तभी तो जाके दोनों टकराएंगे. ओके, सो फॉर कोलिशन यू ए मस्ट बी मोर देन यू बी. सो आफ्टर कोलिशन बोथ एक्सपीरियंसेस फोर्स अकॉर्डिंग टू थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन, राइट? एंड दीज आर द इंडिकेशंस ऑफ फोर्सेस. देन आफ्टर कोलिशन दे मूव in the same direction they are moving, and here final velocity with final velocity, and here also B with final velocity. So this is all about the related figure of conservation of momentum. And then next we have derivation. So in derivation, all these are meanings of the different symbols I have already explained you. And then about FAB, this one is force exerted by ball A on ball B. And FBA means force exerted by ball B on ball A. And for this conservation, two conditions are essential. Number first about speed. Number second is about no other external unbalanced force acting on the two balls. That means there must be no other disturbance. Next we have the continuation of same derivation. We are using here two laws. First, the use of Newton's second law of motion. So second law of motion is F is equal to mv minus u upon t. अब यहाँ पे आप A की बात कर रहे हैं तो सभी में हमने क्या लगा दिया है? A. This is with respect to ball A. ये आपके पास B के लिए है. So here we have used for every case B, right? This is for ball B and this is for ball A. Right? Next we have Newton's third law of motion. So forces are equal and opposite. That means ye wala sign plus ka ho gaya aur ye wala minus ka ho gaya. And same here, from here we have taken the values. And T for both the cases are same. So T and T cancel each other and the same is reflecting in the next step. Right? So same last step is here, the first one, the same step, right? Just remove this bracket, use mathematics, transfer this minus sign to other place and this to here, right? You are observing here V and V, both are final velocities, right? Here initial velocities. So exchange LHS and RHS, you will get this equation. That means MAUA, MBUB is equal to MAVA plus MBVB. This one is the law of conservation of momentum, right? And momentum is singular word, momenta is plural, right? So here you have two momentum, right? That means these two are momenta and this one is sum of momenta. U representing before collision and V is after collision. So sum of momenta before collision is equal to sum of momenta after collision. after collision, and condition is no external unbalanced force acting on them, and this is known as the law of conservation of momentum, and this is very essential from your examination point of view. Everything that means a diagram, then derivation, statement, and the next numerical also, right? We are dealing with numerical of law of conservation of momentum. So we are taking here only one example, 9.7. Just your first essential condition is, for solving any numerical, you must have one pen or pencil, underline the important terms. Like here we have a girl of mass 40 kg, so this one is a girl mass 40 kg, right? Underline this. Jumps with horizontal velocity, underline this. Stationary cart, underline this, right? And then now mass of cart, underline this. What is her velocity as the cart starts moving? Assume no external unbalanced force, right? So first is about this girl MA. Okay, yahan pe problem kya hui hai, aap dekhenge yahan pe this A must be smaller. आप छोटा छोटा करके लिखेंगे, right? Font change हो गया है, right? So MA is 40 kg. So this one is about girl. Then cart is B, right? M बड़ा होना चाहिए, B छोटा होना चाहिए, right? So it is 3 kg. And then we have UA. This girl is initial velocity is 5 m/s, and then stationary cart, that means initially initial velocity of ball B is 0, and then about what is happening here, her velocity as the cart starts. मतलब एक cart है, जैसे आपने वो cart लड़के और लड़की वाला देखा था, okay, in the same manner वो लड़की उस cart पे चढ़ जाती है, that means final velocity are now combined, that means both are on each other, right? And that means the girl is on the cart, that means a final velocity of girl is matching with the final velocity of cart. So here we have taken V and V, right? Apply the statement law of conservation of momentum, right? Use everything, put all values, right? Solve the value of V, you will get the value V is equal to 4.65 m/s. So velocity unit is, SI unit is meter per second, right? Then this is about numerical. So what you have to do, you have to do one correction. जैसे कि आप यहाँ पे देख रहे हो एम ए कितना छोटा लिखा हुआ है, तो एम बड़ा होना चाहिए, ए छोटा होना चाहिए, इन एवरी केस, ओके? ए लाइक दिस मैचिंग विद दिस वन, राइट? सो ओनली वन करेक्शन यू हैव टू डू इन दिस स्लाइड अबाउट योर राइटिंग वर्क, राइट? अदरवाइज एवरीथिंग इज सेम. नेक्स्ट इज अबाउट असाइनमेंट नंबर 4, ये आप ऑलरेडी कर चुके होंगे. देन असाइनमेंट नंबर 5, ये भी आप कर चुके होंगे. एंड असाइनमेंट नंबर 6 इज टुडेज वर्क, राइट? क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, 2, 3 ऑफ योर साइंस टेक्स्ट बुक, पेज नंबर 126. देन एक्सरसाइज पेज 128, क्वेश्चन नंबर 10, 11 यू हैव टू डू. देन पेज 129, क्वेश्चन नंबर 12 and 13 यू हैव टू डू. एंड देन पेज 129, क्वेश्चन नंबर 16 and 17 यू हैव टू डू इन योर कॉपीज. And this is the end of our video session and also of this force and laws motion chapter. Thank you.